Hi, I'm Lady Charmaine, and of course, I got another great interview for you today. I believe everyone probably know my guest by now because she has appeared in some of our favorite television shows. She is a comedian, actress, director, author, and former talk show host. She has appeared in shows like Friends, Ghost Whisperer, Criminal Minds, Whose Line Is It Anyway, and the daytime talk show The Talk. And she's here today to talk about the new season of the animated television show Archer. Help me welcome to the Lady Charmaine Live Show, Miss Aisha Tyler. Welcome.
Hi, how are you?
I am good. And Aisha, so you're a fellow Bay Area native such as myself. You're from San Francisco, California.
Oh, yes, yes. Born, raised, and continue and will always represent the Bay. But I love Sacramento. I used to do a lot of stand-up. I used to drive up there to do stand-up when I was a baby comedian in San Francisco.
Oh, so you call it a baby comedian because you went to a school called McAteer that we all know is called Mac. Because my husband also went to school in San Francisco. He went to Woodrow Wilson. So we're very familiar with you.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. So he went there. So we're familiar with your school. I'm from Richmond. And I was so happy to hear that you were a Bay Area native. And as I was reading your story, Aisha, I thought it was so interesting. It said that basically you started your comedy career at McAteer. Did they have like a special program for comedians or something?
Well, it kind of, yeah. Like, so what we had was a theater department, like a theater program. They had an arts program there. And one of the classes was improv comedy, and that was kind of the beginning. But, you know, I always tell people, when I used to interview people for my podcast, I would say, how did you get started, like, as an actor or whatever? And they would always say, oh, there was a boy or there was a girl. That's always the story, right? So with me, there was a boy, and I really liked him. I followed him into improv class. And then loved it probably, so I stayed. But that boy, you may know, is an Oscar winner, Sam Rockwell. So that was how I got into doing comedy. And did it in high school and college, but was, you know, still thinking I was going to be a lawyer or something like that. So I didn't really start being an actual stand-up until I graduated from college. I was in my 20s.
You know, it's something how you say you wanted to be a lawyer, then you got into comedy. What was that thing that got you, you know, in television and comedy where you said, this is what I want to do?
Oh, wow. It's so funny because I was working and I just moved back to San Francisco from college and I really wanted to perform. And I didn't know what to do because, you know, I'd always been like in class or in a group or whatever. And I thought, well, I'll just try stand up and see if I like it because you don't need an agent or you don't need to know anybody. You don't need a band or,
right,
you know, a setup or you can go do it, you know. And I just tried it one time and I was hooked. I mean, it was just, it's one of those things that either you want to do it or you don't. And, you know, right away, the first time you try. And it wasn't like I got up there and I was hilarious. I wasn't. I got up there. I got like a little half-hearted titter from the bartender, a little laugh of support from the back of the room. Uh-huh. But I was just addicted to it. You know what I mean? And
right.
And I knew right that very first time that I was.
And you're such a very versatile actress because a lot of comedians turn out to be great actors. You know, when you think of the Eddie Murphys, it's like when you make that transition into acting, it seems like a natural progression. And so you went into Criminal Minds, and also we have Whose Line Is It Anyway? And I wanted to know because you're like a female Steve Harvey to me. You have like several different shows going on at one time. I'm like, this girl knows she got it going on. I'm like, when you're a black woman in high demand, it's a beautiful thing. Oh, you're welcome. And so I wanted to know, how do you basically make that transition? Because you go from television, because you have to learn lines. Of course, you have a TV show. And then, of course, we're going to be talking about Archer. And then you're on the talk show. So you have to go from memorizing lines to voicing characters to now you have to be on for a talk show. How do you turn that off when you get home, when you're on so much?
Oh, wow, that's a really good question. Oh, my God. You know, it's interesting. Like, maybe I don't. Maybe that's just when I'm a nightmare. I have no idea. I do think I'm a workaholic. And I mean, I think I do so much stuff because I have all that crazy energy and I need to always be doing. You know, like some people, I think, like their energy or their battery gets charged by doing. For some people, it gets depleted. I'm one of those people that the more I do, the more energy I have. So I don't always wind down. Sometimes I come home and I'm just bouncing off the walls. But I have good friendships and I put that energy to other things, and that's why I keep adding projects. You know, until I left the talk, I was on 4 TV shows. I just directed a movie that's out now. I'm getting ready to direct another movie. So I think I don't come down. I think I'm
going.
I'm gonna be in TMZ one day with like I used to have it in the hospital for exhaustion. Like, that's me. But I do love what I do, and that keeps me going. You know, I feel, I'm very passionate about it, and I feel very fortunate, especially as a woman of color, to be this busy in this business. It's unusual, and I feel very lucky. You know, so I keep hustling because I know how unusual it is to have what I have. So I got to, you know, try to keep it moving.
Right, and then you had the opportunity to be on a great talk show because I don't know if you remember me, but I have been a social media talker on The Talk twice. And so I've had that privilege to be on your show, which has been a blessing. But I know you ended up leaving the show. How agonizing was that for you when the thought came to your mind, I think I have to let something go and it's going to have to be The Talk show? When you had to finally come to
really
the realization.
Mm-hmm. It was really painful, and that is very deceptive of you, because, you know, I think sometimes, like, sometimes decisions, we make decisions, and sometimes they kind of make themselves, in the sense of you see what you want, and you realize to get there, you have to give up something. Do you know what I mean? It was really what it was. Like, I wanted to be a film director for a long time. I finally had an opportunity to direct a film. I saw it in 2016. It was called Actus. AXIS, it's out now on like on demand, iTunes, Amazon, all those things. Anywhere you get your digital films, it's out. And it was my first film, and I thought, well, try this and see how it goes. And it went so well. The movie won a bunch of awards, and it got picked up for distribution. And I thought, great, I want to keep doing this. And there's no way I can become a film director when I make a daily talk show, like the demands of getting up every day and making a talk show 11 months out of the year. Just they're too, you know, it's too incongruous. It's not going to work. And I just had to decide, like, okay, people do this. I'm sure you probably do this all the time. You know, you look and you say, like, where do I want to be in 5 years? Am I taking the steps now to get there?
Right.
And, you know what I mean? And that was it. I just knew I loved to talk. I loved going there every day. It was a great job with people I really cared about. But I couldn't stay there and also pursue my dreams.
Right.
And I went to all the women on the show and talked to them about it. And everybody was so supportive and so kind. And I, you know, you feel, okay, like I'm breaking up the band right now, like I'm pulling the Yoko Ono, just to me, you know, but they were so, so lovely. And actually was just back at the talk last week promoting my movie. And now it just feels like a homecoming every time I go there. And I really love it. Eve took my place and she's amazing. And, and I'm so happy because what I really wanted was them to find somebody great, because that culture, so, you know, those five women, those four women, you know, now five women, like our family to me. So what you really want is you don't want like the new person to come in and like take a pee in the pool.
Right. So amazing.
So like really, I'm just glad they found somebody wonderful to take over, and I'm just thrilled. I'm thrilled every day for them, and then I'm now out here in these. Running these streets, which is what I wanted to do.
Yes, you are. And speaking of running these streets, you are in Archer, which premieres tonight on FXX. Tell us about the character, and tell us a little bit about the show before you go.
So this year, season 9, Archer is entitled Archer Danger Island. And for people who don't know, or people who haven't been following the show, you know, the first few years of the show, we were spies. And then we got thrown out in the cold because of some technicalities, and we became drug dealers for the season of Archer Fight. Then we were running a banana republic in South America. Then we were private investigators in L.A. Then we were living in the 1940s, a film noir Los Angeles, and now we are on a very dangerous island called Danger Island. And I play, my character's changed a little bit. My character's name is now Princess Lana Lua Kalani. She's the princess of the Chinese South Pacific island of Mikimoto. And Archer is a very low-functioning alcoholic seaplane pilot who has a sidekick, Cracker, who's an actual sentient talking parrot. So it's just madness. It's just madness that you know from Archer. All of the same hilarious hijinks, everybody drinking too much and cursing too much and having too much sex with each other. All of that comedy is still there. But now on this island that has talking combative monkeys and all kinds of dangerous perils awaiting. It's really like a big kind of classic Hollywood adventure this season.
And it's an adult animation. So just to let parents out there know, this is an adult animation, something just for you.
Yeah.
not something just for you.
It is a cartoon, but it is not a cartoon.
Correct.
I don't watch cartoons. I'm like, this is not a cartoon.
Absolutely.
Yeah, not with church. You're not plopping things down in front of it because we'll learn a bunch of stuff you haven't talked to them about yet.
And I just want to remind everyone, you can actually follow this show on Instagram and Twitter at ArcherFXX. And also, you can also follow Aisha at Aisha Tyler. Again, Aisha, I want to thank you so much for coming on the show. And I want to remind the audience to make sure that you tune in tonight to FXX for It's Archer Dangerous Island. And again, thank you so much for coming on the show. And I got to have you back.
Oh, what a joy. I would love to come back. Thank you so much. That was wonderful.
You're welcome, and have a blessed day, okay?
You too. Thank you.
Bye-bye.